Here we are. Hello, Big Patch Day. Let's see how it performs. From what I've heard, apparently this patch is a great improvement in terms of VR. They say performance is much, much better. Let me hear the sound.
Hello, Big Patch Day. Let's see how it
More than 8 gigabytes of download. It's quite the patch, huh? Quite the patch. Start Discord as well, just in case I might need it. And I tested the game briefly to see that it worked. Honestly, I could see some improvement, but not to the extent that people were saying in the forum. Like you read in the forum, they say, "It's incredible, it runs perfectly in VR now." Well, from what I've seen, yes, you have some better numbers in terms of FPS. It's not like the game is incredibly smooth. Anyway, let's go. They say they also improve spotting. Anyway, the engine is much different now. Apparently, it's based on the fair shading, whatever that means, and you can adapt to different type of full screen anti-aliasing, which I don't even know if it applies to VR. Anyway, let's experiment with it and see how it performs indeed. It's quicker to start, it seems. Did it start so quickly earlier? I don't know. It might be that the servers are half empty because unless earlier they were. People were still downloading the patch, I mean. Probably, I don't know. Or perhaps it was the time zone difference. It could be that now they're more populated. Wings was still running a later war scenario, which I would prefer, honestly. It's got many more interesting planes, but whatever we do. And in terms of settings, yeah, if I go to the graphics, I can see indeed that we have full screen or MS anti-aliasing. But anyway, I keep it off. Yeah, I always try to keep everything pretty low, except for what I need for spotting, because the game runs badly already. Even though apparently now it might not. Let's see. Well, in the main menu, it hits the cap of 80 FPS, as you can see. It doesn't move even. The average is moving, but the average means nothing. FPS is 80, full stop. So let's see how it goes on Wings of Liberty. This will be very interesting, I guess. Ah, of course, I want in the small people. It's not full like some days, but there's more people. Of course, I won't have 3D Migoto to zoom with. 3D Migoto has to be upgraded. It's a completely different engine now. The shaders are completely different, and 3D Migoto at the moment doesn't work. 3D Migoto, if you don't know, it's the mod that lets you zoom in VR with three different levels. In fact, people are already complaining because yes, the VR zoom is much inferior. If I were playing with an Oculus, honestly, I wouldn't even try. With the hidden resolution of the index, it's possible that the standard zoom will be enough. Honestly, I don't know. From the brief test that I did earlier, it seems that spotting is more or less the same. It's not like spotting is harder. It's identifying the planes that become harder because you cannot see the final details as well. But I mean, let's try. It's either this or we don't play until 3D Mikoto is out, and of course, I prefer the first option. What's going on? It's loading. Hey, Bruise, hello, thank you for liking the stream. Starting. There's also a new plane, but not on Steam. They only have it on their own website at the moment. LA5, LA9, the LA9, yes, I wouldn't dislike using it. Also, honestly, I don't know why it wasn't included from the game until now. It's a plane that played a major role during the Battle of Stalingrad. Let me see the player numbers. More or less even. Shall we go with Germans? I guess, to make something different. Last time we played the Russians. So let's go from Shiver, I guess. Coalition change penalty. Ah, because when I did the test I was on Soviet side. Okay then, I guess let's stay Soviet, it's okay. And besides, look what we have here. We have the Spitfire, we have the P-47. You have a lot of interesting planes. What about the Orl? 820. Rather than picking the Spitfire, I would go with the LA5FN, honestly. It's more my style. I don't know. With the Spitfire, I always find myself blacking out in this game. And yes, it's not conducive to a great number of air victories. Let's try not to make my life too difficult. The LA5FN is reliable, easy to use, fast. Flies well at high altitude. Yeah, as you can see, it's better, but not incredibly so. In the airfield, it goes between 50, 40 used to go below 40 in the airfield, so it's an improvement, yes, but we'll see once I'm in the air. This is exactly the same scene as when I connected to test the game earlier. There was the same PA2 to my left. For a moment there I thought it's the same guy that never took off. He was waiting for me to come back, of course. Why not? This thing has been running for a while, I guess. Yeah, I tested it a couple of hours ago. We'll see what comes next then. Let's make this first hour good then. Try to influence the battle somehow. RPM, no mixture control on the LA5. Okay, open the radiators just a bit. I can take off straight, it's a fire. And a very powerful one at that. No problem like that. Okay, except for the fact that I pushed my stick too much and broke the propeller. What a wonderful beginning. I won't get penalized for it, luckily, because of course I will still be on the airfield. And look at that, I broke the wing for good measure. Well, let's pretend this never happened and start again. Hey, thank you for the like, even if at the moment of my inglorious failure, this doesn't normally happen to me when I go with LA5FM. It's either. Okay, that was half terrible, or should I say 100% so. So the airfield is now under attack, so taking off air would have been actually a good move. Anyway, let's try again, and this time without pushing the stick forward. Ah, this guy is using a different skin. Unfortunately, we don't see the pilot because I keep having a low detail. Hey, thank you for the follow, Jason. And now we will take off, I swear. This is the good one. Pumping fuel, closing canopy. The base is still under attack, so let's hurry, come on. You see, in fact, I did it on purpose. I wanted to escort the A20. I waited for the A20 to take off, no? I mean the PA2. The A20 is still there. Okay. Never happened to me, honestly. It was a surprise. It never happened to me before. Did they change something about the plane with the new update? I guess it could be, no? It never did it. Or maybe I also just pushed the stick too much. It was my fault. Anyway, is this base under attack or not? Apparently, no longer. There is no flashing red icon. What about the landing gear? Okay, double checking that it's up. Ah, turn on the lights in the cabin. Makes seeing the instruments better in general. So as you can see, this is the zoom that we will have today. This is also the performance that we will have today. Does it look like it runs incredibly good to you? I'm not sure. Honestly, for me, it's better but not perfect. Still, we are at the airfield, though. Our factory is under attack. Okay, let's fly southward. Of course, the bomber will be long gone, but there might be another one, or he might be returning there by the time I'm at the factory. In the meantime, I'll try to find a wingmate of some type, something that I can fly with. I didn't the PA2 just take off? I'll try to find someone without coordinating. It will be as difficult as getting a kill, basically. Where did you go? PA2! It won't be flying to the factory, besides it will be attacking an airfield. No, let's... attacking a target, I mean. Let's just go south and see what we can achieve today. I hope better than the last time. To find the sweet spot again. Ever since I started toying with the visor again, yes, I'm constantly adjusting. I mean, it's not that bad over level of zoom. I would say it's like the 3D Migoto medium one, which of course I never use because the maximum one is better. But anyway, like I said, these are naughty. The clouds seem to be rendered better. Don't they? I mean, they're more compact, almost. I hope they didn't make it harder to see things stand out in the cloud. It was one of the few advantages in VR. If not the only one. Okay, get out of boosted mode now. We're at decent altitude. Where is my altitude, by the way? It's that, huh? Yeah, 2007. Heading straight south to the objective that we want to defend. This is the body blood map anyway, eh? It's the one that is way more demanding in terms of resources. So to be running like this is actually an achievement, because look at that. Hey, thank you for the like. Gabriele, ciao, bentornato. No, come dicevo, 70 frame al secondo, 70 frame per second, it's a big improvement. In terms of numbers, in terms of smoothness feeling of the VR, I don't know. Because look at the graph. It still has, you can see the graph is correct, I think. It still has these weird yellow spikes that are what is contributing basically to the feeling of non-smoothness that this game has, and it's the only one really. It's its characteristic. By now I'm used to it. In the beginning it even made me feel a bit sick. Okay, begin scanning the horizon, huh? Also, it's now the zoom at toggle. Ah, wait, I'm off course. While I was... Of course I'm off course. Let's go south. South. Factory it is. The factory is a very juicy target. I bet enemy bombers will be heading for it. Our ship's destroyed. So they're attacking on more than one front at the same time. How's the player number at the moment? No, no, it's not full, but there's plenty. There's plenty of players. Spotting the planes at a distance is not worse without redeeming auto, but once the chase starts and you try to understand what you are actually chasing, then you are at disadvantage, I think, compared to normal players. Because you cannot put your face closer to the monitor, that's the problem. Even if I zoom, in fact, the normal players, the monitor players, still have the super zoom. They just zoom and then move their face closer to the monitor. If I move my case closer, I just move inside the aircraft. I don't magnify anything. Also, the fact that everything is in 3D is a mixed blessing. Better for the duel in its final part, but harder to spot. Okay, to tell things apart. You see, there's a couple of planes there. I don't know if it shows up in your view, but they're clearly visible even without 3D Migot. In fact, I would say spotting has been improved in general with the patch. This is the feeling that I have. I'm not sure I could see these things over there without 3D Migot before the patch. We're almost at the factory. I will presume that to be a friend who is guarding the objective, but you never know. It also looks big, hard to tell, because normally I would be zooming more. Wait a sec, am I looking at a balloon? Yes, I'm looking at a spotting balloon, probably. Okay, never mind that. Been the bane of my existence ever since the beginning of the modern plot map. They always look so suspicious and yet never are indeed a threat. That's the factory, it seems. Well, it looks fairly factory-shaped, so to say. It's also been hit already, pretty hard, it's making, missing quite a few buildings. Let's begin a patrol circuit, just in case an enemy might show up. As you can see, it's got one, two spotting balloons. Our factory 2407 is under attack, okay. It's mine, it's my factory, so an enemy is getting closer. I used to think that when he says under attack, the enemy would be right on top of the objective and already bombing it. In fact, it doesn't work like that. It just means an enemy is in the area. This of course changes everything. The enemy will be coming from the right, I think. Potentially dangerous to fly close to the balloons. You can hit not just the balloon, but its wire as well. Runs from it to the ground. Should be checking my six more regularly here. We're actually above the war zone. And also in between clouds that make missing the enemy quite likely. Of course the opposite is also true. So it becomes a spotting war essentially. It always is in this game. It always, almost always is. Hey, thank you for the like, Cody. We're playing Sturmovik with the new patch. That seems to improve the performance considerably. Doesn't completely solve the problems of the game, but makes quite the difference. At the moment I'm guarding our factory from the enemy attack. But apparently it was coming from the message I got, but I don't see any threat. This is part of the game, of course. The waiting is part of the game. Well, eventually I start moving towards the enemy objectives. Fortunately, the server is less than full, which compounds the problem of finding someone to shoot at. You know very well how this game works. Shall we move? But they got the message, the factory is under attack. The moment I leave, they will come for it, I know, I just know. Our vehicles is under attack, 24 or 7. Ok, let's go to the vehicles, 05. Also... Well, no, it's still they're closer to the enemy base. I thought they would be coming back through this location, but indeed it's not like that. Just keeping an eye in case it should go. A bomb should go off, but apparently no, it's not gonna happen very soon. Okay, the vehicles are apparently sitting past the city of Nivelle on the river. So there. It might be that the notice got triggered because the enemy was overflying them, because it seems strange that they would attack the vehicles before the factory. The factory is much easier to hit and worth way more points. Normally vehicles are the last thing they hit, they're so hard to find as well. Let me check the six from time to time. Eventually I learned to actually do it. Enemy hacker spotted at the diurnal airfield. Okay. Cheese, the one to the north. I think they're hitting mostly the north at this time. I should have gone there. But anyway, we're here. Let's try to protect the vehicles, I guess. Our stronghold is under attack in 1904, unfortunately. Yeah, they're in the north. We very well understood it now. I might turn to the right and start moving northward at this point. Wait a sec, I spotted something. Okay. What might it be? The way it's heading eastward makes me think it's an enemy. Let me see, trying to enter the cloud at an angle where he might not see me. Unless he's already seen me and maneuvering to my six. Which unfortunately appears like it, because I don't see him anymore. Let's climb above the clouds. It's a safer bet, I guess. Well, I don't think he might be able to get me so easily with all these clouds, but people are very good at this game. Hey, thank you for the like, Harsh. Welcome to the stream. I'm seeking the enemy plane that I possibly just spotted in between the clouds. Possibly, not sure. Okay. If he left the cloud, he will have moved toward the factory, I guess. Anyway, he certainly hasn't spotted me. It was very difficult. And Matthias as well, thank you for the like. Let me see. No, I think it's gone, it's gone. And besides, we're guarding nothing here, essentially. I might pass above the vehicles 1 second and turn the right to the factory. The vehicles are possibly around there, where the river makes a bend. There's even a bridge, it will be by the bridge. Oh, here we have our combat. We found our target again. Too bad I have no idea which is the enemy, but of course one is going down. We might as well go for the other, I guess. I might be able... No, identification is impossible. Not without the 3D Migoto. I mean, we can pretend it's an enemy. Assume it, I mean. And climb for it. I'll check in 6 from time to time. Unfortunately, I'm coming from the direction of his kill. That he will be looking forward toward to confirm it, I guess. Yes, it also disappeared. Wow, how did he manage to disappear like that? He's in the cloud, probably. Here he is, I saw him. For a brief second, he entered the cloud when he saw me, probably. So he knows I'm here. And here you are. And I still cannot tell without 3D Migoto. I think it's a German. What do you say? No, wait a sec. This angle is difficult to tell. Doesn't look so German, actually. I don't think it's German. No. Wow, it certainly took me some time to tell. No, because if it's a German, what would it be? You know that honestly, now it's harder without the zoom to tell the planes apart is way harder. I could tell that it's not an enemy, but mostly by the way he was maneuvering. And only that. Still not sure what it is. Well, I also suck at identifying planes. It looks like a Tempest to me, but that's impossible because they're not in this scenario. Guys, what is that really? It's an American plane, I think. Huh? The PF-40? It's crazy. I cannot seriously tell what this is. Well, okay, it's now my wingmate, I guess. With truncated wings like that. Could it be a Spitfire with truncated wings? There is an option to clip them, to add the shorter wings that no one takes. I think it's that. It's the Spitfire without the tip of the wings. But anyway, I could tell that he was in German in time, and this is good, otherwise I would have a friendly kill on my shoulder. I think I should stay with him. At least it makes the stream a bit more interesting, since I cannot find the enemy. There would be two of us not finding the enemy. And besides, co-op makes the game more fun, no? It's also slow enough to be a Spitfire. Wow. Okay, that's simply a Yak and it's a normal Russian plane, I can tell it at once. Holy crap. What did I have on my tail? I think it was the Spitfire, I hope. Yeah, no, anyway, it's plan. It's the Russian plan. That was a moment of. Okay, no, we're good, we're good. No, there's three of us, eh? We can't find the enemy. It's getting better. Imagine a poor German gets here. Three very dangerous pilots pounce on him, or maybe two very dangerous pilots and one half confused guy that I won't state the name of. To try and perhaps. If you're covering an A20, then follow high and behind me, not right next to me. Well, you got a point. What sort of cover would he be offering if he's to the right of the A20? Here we stand, above the vehicles, waiting for something to happen. How strong will this under attack? I think we should move to the north of the map, honestly. They're just entertaining one attacking here. Okay, that's still one of our friends, I presume. Let's practice diving, I guess, just to make sure. It's true that it's easier to follow things that are toward the ground now. Okay, it's the Russian yak. As opposed to the I don't know what yak. I have to specify, it's the Russian yak. Well, this is boring. Getting bored together is still getting bored, so let's move northward where the action seems to be. I think he had the same idea as me. Yeah, figure out what that is. I also lost it. Damn, I could see it so well. It was moving toward the ground and then poof. We're playing still more eco, right? They might have made improvements, but it's still more or less the same. Spotting things is a chore. I don't check my six nearly enough, that's the truth. I should only fly planes that have a rear view mirror, I guess. This can have a rear view mirror, but the pilot places it like in front of the canopy. It covers completely your view of the outside. It's not very practical. The planes that have the mirror outside are better in my opinion. Okay, this is the enemy stronghold that we're reaching. I should avoid overflying it, thus exposing myself to anti-air for no reason at all.
You should fly the BF-110, mate.
Hey! Hi, it's Chris! Hey, hello!
What server are you on?
Wings of Liberty, the only populated one at this time.
True.
You wanted to fly another nation, Germans?
No, no, no. First I want to join you, sir.
Okay, come to Wings of Liberty. I'm flying aligned at the moment in an LA-5FM above the front lines. The game runs better, huh? It's true. It runs much, much better. I have now 50 frames per second on the bottom plat map, the one that used to run horribly. I can't wait to see the effect of the update on the normal Russian map that I used to run already well. Hey, I'm happy you came. Let's play Sturmovik together for the first time.
I've got nearly 40 minutes.
40 minutes, okay. Yeah. Well, it might be enough to do a sortie or two, depending on how long of a sortie we manage to do. Unfortunately, I'm not finding the enemy. They're all in the northern part of the map. In fact, when you enter the match, try to spawn in one of the northern airfields. I think I made a mistake in that regard. Unfortunately, it's hard to tell where they're going to attack. And I overflew the factory and the vehicles. There just was no enemy. Now I'm moving north. I'm currently...
But I'm spawning in the north with an LA fight.
Okay, in the north, so the urn.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm currently 2105 keypad 2 and moving northward to our stronghold that was under attack some time ago. Anyway, I'll eventually have to refuel. I've been flying until now with no results. And I'm now below half tank. Okay, now about 10 kilometers from the stronghold. Is it running better for you?
It runs every time good.
Ah, for you it's always run well. The problem is in VR it's a very demanding game. I don't think a computer that can run it perfectly exists in VR. It's not perfectly optimized, so there was an improvement, yeah, indeed. It's much more pleasant to play. Also because in VR when it doesn't run well, you get some sense of sickness, which is always unpleasant. Okay, I think I have eyes on the stronghold objective, which at the moment doesn't seem to be under attack. I have no visual on any target. Are you coming to our stronghold objective? It's under attack, by the way, it says. 1904, yeah, that one.
Yeah.
Okay, keeping my eyes peeled on the jacket. At the moment I don't see anything moving above it. Yet it keeps saying under attack, under attack. Doesn't look much like a stronghold. It's more like a factory. Look at the guy in chat. Press Alt F4 to power off your plane. Yes, the objective now is visibly damaged. The game only renders the damage once you are below a certain distance. And yet I don't see anyone attacking it. There's a bomb crater, but not bomb. Must be very unlucky today. I find no one wherever I go. It's a bomb crater a bit to the side of the objective. Maybe it's the crater from a downed airplane, one of the two. Are you in view of the objective yet?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Once you are, tell me so we can try and join up. I can move a bit to the enemy tank column. I want to see Our vehicles at 2405 is now under attack. That's the other side of the map by now. Incredible. Every time I come, the attack seems to be already over. Ooh, someone is shooting me, okay. Suddenly there's three planes all around me over the objective. Stronghold. And I might have my eyes on what looks very much like a Focke-Wulf. Yeah, I think it's that. Accelerating fast. They probably they will get me. Because there's two men.
Button to close the cabin.
We're above above the stronghold proper. There. Okay, I'm accelerating after this Focke-Wulf, or at least I hope it is. There's also a friend here. In fact the other planes were friendlies. No, I might be good then. Attacking him is mocking. Now careful, unfortunately I'm too fast. I will have to do another pass. That's not a Focke-Wulf. I think it's a BF. I'm not so sure. Anyway, it should be mine. Okay, it's going down. I wonder if I'll get the kill or the other guy will. Apparently, the other guy did. Well, okay, I will have the assist, I presume. Let me see. No, not even that. And what the hell? The game must hate me. Okay. That should be the guy that got my kill in place of me. Hey Pius, hello, welcome. How did your chemistry, biology lesson go? We are now playing Sturmovik together with Chris. And I just took part in a dogfight but couldn't get the kill anyway. I think I damaged the enemy. Run by some chap in a bing yesterday. That was annoying, says that guy. Just got a new headset. You got it, Pius? What headset? You got a... Ah, you had ordered an headset the other day, right? You told me. But it was the Oculus Go, or wasn't it? Don't remember. Tell me about it. I think we must be close now. Are you at the stronghold yet, Chris? Huh?
I need a few seconds to get there.
Excuse me?
I need a few seconds.
Ah, okay, okay.
I'm on my way.
Alright. Well, guys, I think I should have got the assist there. Maybe I will be awarded it when I land. I should have damaged him on my first pass. I saw smoke come out of the plane. Now we're back to guarding duty, I guess. The uncanny thing is how easily all the guys that materialized themselves disappear. Where the heck did they go? I think after this sortie we go with a bomber, since apparently there are no enemy. Ah, a new microphone, not a VR headset. Ah, this is still a very, very good news for when we play together. Finally we'll be able to understand one another. Because this is actually wonderful news for me. I'm glad that you bought a new microphone. Tomorrow at this time I'll be doing War Thunder. I'll try to play the games one per day. One day Sturmovik, one day War Thunder. Well, I think in a while I'll have to go and refuel. Not doing it yet, no, but soon. Target has just been bombed. Yeah. Who did it? It's just been bombed. We'll be trying to speed away westward, I guess. Absolutely no visual. Ooh, I got an enemy on my tail. Okay, turning guard. Apparently, he lost control a bit, but he'll be diving back. And now we have another plane there as well. I will assume them both to be German. Unfortunately, it's very hard to tell without the super zoom. I'll keep turning, as long as I turn, I'm a difficult target in an LA5. No visual. And apparently they also lost sight of me. Ah no, they're in combat with someone else. I see tracers. Here you are then. Okay, three planes following one another. Let's try to go back up. Unfortunately, I lost a lot of altitude when I was evading. But they're also losing altitude during the dogfight. I'm keeping boosted mode on for the time being. The guys that have entered into the cloud are now invisible to me. Checking six, they're clear. What about him? Ooh, here you go again. Okay, that's German, I think. He's turning towards me. And no, he's not turning towards me. The opposite direction. And he's also slower than me. This is excellent. Increase the speed, increase the speed. It's a Focke-Wulf this time, isn't it? And I hope I'm not doing something stupid because I'll probably be shooting him now. To me, he looked German. I'm not 100% sure because the zooming, yeah, it's limited. And I hit him, he's now smoking. That's German, come on, it cannot be anything else. Okay, slowing down. And now I did some damage. He might be going down. Not yet. In fact, he's maneuvering pretty well. I gotta try to employ my superior maneuverability. Especially since he's damaged, but I'm in danger because he also has a wingman. Predictably, as always. Never follow someone for more than 2 minutes in this game. He will have a wingman coming. What's happened? My engine just shut off. First engine failure. Ah, that's not good. was I too much in. I think I was in boosted mode for too long. Okay, this is the end of my dogfight, I guess. Well, not very glorious ending. I think I might still get the kill because the guy was very heavily damaged. He might be unable to return to base. But I will have to ditch my airplane, I'm afraid, for such a stupid reason. Yeah, I overstressed the LA5 FN engine, I guess. And here you come again, he really wants to kill me, huh? That's very little I can do at this point, except for crash landing without an engine. I'll actually crash land very close to the city of Lokeren, where I presume I'll go to a bar and have a sweet breakfast. in the European tradition. Yeah, boom, I broke the propeller for good measure. Hushman, ah, you should have done barrel roll on top of it and still be on his back. Well, I tried, man. I tried, something didn't work properly, unfortunately, and I think it was my engine. I also flipped the plane, and this is the end of my first sortie. At this point, since we've been flying for like 15 minutes without, no, even more than that, without doing anything, let's go and bomb. Let's go and bomb. It's a forced landing. I tell you, I might get the kill. The guy is not returning to base. He was too heavily damaged and far away from the base. I think I might get the kill. And now, since it's in the description of the game, I'm spawning an A20 from Melsbrook, I guess. And I'll go... Well, if I go from there, what can I hit? Nothing at this point. No, I'll go from Melsbrook to the Stronghold. To the Stronghold.
I will try to be your gunner.
Okay. That might be interesting. That will be very interesting. A20B. What's the color of the terrain? It's green. Can we have a green? Yeah, this one looks fairly nice. Bogatyr. Ha! The Bogatyr is a Russian hero of traditional folklore. Like a wandering knight of sort. And I'll get the 16 100M bombs, which are pretty good. Okay, spawning. I wonder if I'll get the kill. I wonder. He was heavily damaged. I could see the smoke coming out of its engine. Alright.
I'm be your top gunner.
Okay. You couldn't configure your controls or something like that?
Yeah.
Maybe I can help you in some way. Okay, anyway. Spawning. I mean, turning on the engine. I think from Melsbrook, we can go to the Stronghold. I overviewed that target. It's got a lot of buildings outside and inside the castle. That will be very easy targets for the bombs. Also, the A20 carries a lot of them, so it will be actually possible to complete the story objective. Now, watch me find all the fighters that I couldn't fight in 30 minutes of fighter gameplay. I'm sure they will all come running to me. It's more or less my experience. Okay, right engine has started. I see you in my rear gunner station.
Yeah.
Left engine is starting. Okay. Mixture, RPM, 100%. This time we gotta actually follow the runway, I guess. This is pretty cool. I never flew the entire mission with a human gunner. It might be a good chance to perhaps achieve something for a change, which for me is pretty rare. No, in bombing it's easy. I mean, in bombing you just go to the objective. It's actually a lot of fun to bomb in this game. More than War Thunder, I would say. What's this smoke that I see on the ground? We are being strafed at the moment, it seems.
Yeah.
Okay, that's not good. Not much I can do about it either. Except turning for the runway. I hope I'm turning to the correct way of the runway, or should I go the other way? Well, there's no time. We are also under attack. Lowering the flaps and go. Yeah, the strafing might be a problem. Ah, yeah, I should turn on the lights. I think I can take off. Nice. And now turn to the Stronghold indeed. Raising the flaps. Lowering the mixture, because otherwise this thing smokes like a factory. Ah yes, and I gotta close the flaps or the plane will shake like crazy. The inlet coal shutters. I think I was supposed to turn them on even after starting the engine. You already can turn them on fighting. Okay. Whoever was attacking the ground at that time was either not an enemy or not a threat to us anyway. So I can go straight over Bruxelles from there to the enemy stronghold. Look how big it is. The thing that I like in this game compared to War Thunder is that everything is to scale. The cities are actually as big as they should be. there feels too, and when you go high, you go really high. War Thunder, especially in VR, doesn't have a real sense of size. Everything looks like it's a model, basically. It's a small-scale rendition of reality. Here it's much closer to what you would actually see, I think. And presence in general is better. You feel really inside the plane. Like, this is the reason the game was so nice to me from the very beginning when I tried it in VR. I think it's got better VR for what constitutes the immersion factor, but then worse performance, of course, because War Thunder runs so well, and that's a great asset to have, of course. Yes, Brussels.
Ah, it's a balloon.
Huh?
I spotted the balloon.
Ah, yeah, the balloon, yes. They always get me too. They seem so hostile. You can actually crash into the wire that holds the balloon as well. It happened too.
Yeah. Where do you want to bomb?
The stronghold, the enemy stronghold. The blue objective on 2204. Watch. Then we finish in 10 minutes. Ooh, I don't know if we will be able to do it. I'll increase power. Let's try. Unfortunately, it's late. It's late. It's been running for a lot of time because earlier, a couple of hours ago, I tested the game to see whether it worked with the patch, and they were already running this battle. But the shape of the city is so interesting as well, with all the districts. It looks like something you would build in Sin City. It's very detailed.
Yeah.
You have the industrial area over there. There was even
a good place to bomb.
Yes, except it's not. It's on outside at the moment, I think, so I wouldn't do it. Come on, it's about 12 kilometers to the stronghold. I might already be able to see it. Let me spot its position. Well, there is no frame of reference with rivers or anything else, so I'll have to go by eye. I think it's that, yeah. Yes, I'm on course. Well, 10 minutes, I mean, it's not impossible to achieve it. This is also a pretty fast plane. We are going... where is the speed? What sort of pilot am I? It's covered by the overlay, I think. Yeah, 220 miles per hour. For a bomber, I mean. Well, it's not really a bomb, a ground attack plane. There's something flying over the objective, unfortunately. Now I see it. Might be problematic for us. Let me see. I lost it, but there was a plane.
Yeah, right two, side, right two. Side.
There's two planes right above the airfield.
Right side.
To our right side, okay, so it's our escort, good.
Left side, something engaging us, I think.
Ooh.
9 o'clock,
huh? Ah, I see it, now I see it. You have good eyes as always. I think I'll go straight for the jetty because the map will end soon. I'll try to strike it before time is over. It's also pretty close, I think. Here it is. I mean, let's try to do a quick run. I'll actually dive and increase speed. Now up to 300 miles per hour. I think the buildings to the left look more high value. They're like big hangars. In fact, now that I get closer, I see that they have been already destroyed. You know that there is no clear objective that is still standing, opening the bomb doors anyway. I guess I can bomb that line of small things. It's been already hit pretty hard. Well, let's try to do even more damage. I'll go over these buildings here. Bomb, and then I guess these buildings here, a couple of bombs. Then we go around it, because there's only a bunch of buildings all scattered this way and that. I couldn't see the bombs go off, unfortunately. Normally I use the rear gunner view. I hope they were on target. Ah, this is the stronghold proper now in front of me, but it looks completely destroyed because it's darkish color, which seems to indicate that. These little buildings over there.
Oh, are gunner, also... are you shooting?
Yeah, I shot, I strafed the target a bit. Sorry, I should have told you. Okay, well, the bombs were on target.
Good hit.
Yeah, but did they count? I don't read any kill message for some reason. I don't know what has already been damaged and what hasn't. I guess I could try to hit the big tower in the center. It's like a water tank of sorts.
Ooh.
Someone is attacking us.
Yeah, when I'm...
Okay. And in fact, I have some trouble keeping straight.
It was coming out of the sun.
Okay. Okay, it will be coming back. Let me see. There's another one. Well, whatever damage I did is all the damage we'll do. It's all the damage we will do, but tell you what, there is no reason really to retreat, since the map will end in like 2 minutes.
I'm dead.
Ooh.
Damn it!
I'm still alive. I'm still flying. Let's try to destroy some more of the objective before the end. Come on, bombs, bombs.
It was 3 or 4 fighters.
I think I'll just crash into the tower. No, in fact I didn't.
And
but now they also kill me. Yes, I'm going down. Let's see how much damage I did. I'm not even sure I damaged anything. Because the truth is, it looks still standing, but most buildings were destroyed, I think. Well,
the
at least we had some...
gone on my map.
Ah, it's gone? Then I destroyed
it.
Ah, well, that wasn't too bad. Let me see. Only 2 buildings. But apparently they were enough to take out the objective, yeah. Well, so it wasn't a waste. I think these were...
Fighters.
Ah. Well, okay.
Let's do one more one.
I don't think we have the time. We will never reach the objective in time. Also, for some reason, I lost priority on the window or something. Yeah, I kicked out of it. I think we won't be able to reach the objective again, but let's try. Why not? Steal from Melsbrook, I guess, to the armored column. Should I pick a different bomber? No, the A20 is the faster one.
It's good, it's good.
It's the faster one and also the most fun to use. Next map, we do Germans, and the Germans have cooler bombers. If you want to be again with the German planes, we will have a good time, I think.
First of all, I want to check my controls.
What's the problem? I might be able to give you some ideas.
I'm not sure what it is. For some reason, it won't fit with my setup. Sometimes it didn't connect with my router, sometimes not with my joystick.
It doesn't, basically, it doesn't detect the axis of the two things. It could be, I remember this game for me had a problem with the joystick number IDs. There's a file hidden in the folder somewhere that allows you to rearrange their numbers. Do you have many joystick controllers connected to your PC? Like more than the two? Only these two?
These three, yeah.
Because for me it was that for a period. When I had two different set of pedals, one was number too high. And when I exchanged the number in that file, then it started working again. Okay, rolling. I guess we'll be hitting the tanks and vehicles now. Let me unzoom. The armored column, yeah. It's a weird and not very well optimized game, unfortunately. And so I see why you could have that sort of problem. It's given me all sorts of problems along the course of its history. Okay. Rolling in the same direction as before, which by the way I think is wrong. This is the shortest.
It's good.
It's good, in fact. Yeah, okay. Rolling. Let me see my speed. It's covered perfectly by the overlay, but I can sort of see it. 100 miles per hour. 120, which I guess is liftoff speed. Let's go fast again, because there's not much time left. Ah, if we go German, we can fly the 110 together. That's cool. That's a cool plan. Even perhaps as a gunner, you might have more fun in the JU, I think. Or maybe even the 111. Okay, flat setup, and it's over. I imagine as much.
No.
It was 10 minutes before we even reached the objective. Well, I did some points, so it wasn't a complete waste. Did they get the air kill in the end? No, well, that's unfair. I'm sure I damaged him plenty, but apparently he managed to return to base. Oh well.
The better pilots are on the German side.
They always are in this game, yes, it's true. If you want to win, you better play German. It's true. It's my experience. It's very hard to get kills as a Russian. They also have more pilots in general. And in fact, today is the usual. Look at this. There's like 31 German planes and 20 players from the Russian side. It's the usual thing of this server. Playing Russian, basically, it's hard mode. And let's play Germans then. I mean, one each. One time Russian, one time German. Anyway, to try and even the team is useless. In this game, there will always be that disparity. Like twice as many people in the German side. Okay, it's apparently loading. Now it looks like he crashed, but normally he starts after a bit. Yeah, let's fly the 110 now. Okay, the loading has started. Hey Cody, hi, yes, the thrill of flying indeed. Some Sturmovik, please be patient, it's loading the next map. Yeah, it's loading it. Wanted to see the patch notes while we wait. There should be a news area or something here. Okay, never mind, it started already. I think they shortened the loading times also with the patch. Well, this seems like it to me. Okay, then we go, I guess. Let's do a quick strike on the field warehouse. Why not? From Marinovka. But I guess if it's the first strike, I'll pick something that can carry some more bombs than the 110, meaning the JU-88, which is also fast. So perhaps we will come to our destination before the enemy becomes a problem, and I'll pick the 6 250 bombs, so pretty big bombs, and that's it. Okay, I did plenty of damage with these bombs in the previous runs that I had starting. Spawning, and we're on the runway, I mean we are on the taxiway, parking area, wherever we are, so that I can start the engine. Come on. Oh, the German bombers are just more fun to fly. Okay. Starting the engines. You're still loading. Well, okay, you can join anyway, even while I'm in flight, since you'll be the gunner, it's okay. Left engine started. On the lights. Look at this, there's only 6 people in the Soviet side. It's ridiculous, they should enforce player numbers. Ridiculous that you have this kind of disparity. Makes the Russian side unplayable and the German side less fun to play as well. Probably I should stop flying Russian all together if I want to have fun. This is a sadly the truth. Hi Tate, welcome. Welcome to the stream. We're rolling with the Ju-88 going to bomb the enemy field warehouse. So let's move toward the taxiway. I guess this the runway runs from there, yeah. Easy now, don't overdo it, there's no mixture control. There should be a radiator that I can control though, if I were a man. But I best concentrate on taking off, that comes next. These are not the easiest planes to take off in. Okay, I think I'm out of the taxiway, but as long as I go slow, it's not a problem. And anyway, I'm finding the runway to my right. Okay, put it in position, and I guess RPM 100%, throttle takeoff mode, let's do it! Important thing with this plane is to remember that there's a certain delay, and I said it and I broke it. When you... I knew it would happen, because it happened to me so many times. Okay, I got a respawn. The problem with the Ju-88 is, when you start to press the brake to straighten it, it doesn't do it outright. It does it with a certain delay. If you don't take the delay into consideration, you overcompensate, and this happens, unfortunately. Both times, the first takeoff is a failure. I'm making another attempt. If it doesn't succeed this time either, I'll go with another plane, but I guess, let's try. Damn, it's annoying also because I intended to hit the target as soon as possible, but unfortunately, yeah, if you make such mistakes, ultimately you gotta pay the price. Starting the engines again. Atomic Buttocks, that's some name. We can have up to 3 human gunners in this plane. Huh? I think he starts this one first. And at 100 RPM he starts. If these are RPM, honestly, I don't know. Here it goes. Not yet. I think the RPM is the one on the left. The one on the right is temperature, yeah. So 100 degrees. And there you go. Let's have another attempt. RPM, engine, okay. Throttle, come on, don't do anything stupid. This time, for a change. I gotta use both the steering with the tail and the braking to keep it straight, I guess. The problem was that earlier I tried to steer only by using the brake, which is bad, it's too hard sometimes, and makes the plane do what it did. Anyway, now it seems I'm straight on the runway, and in fact I won't touch the brakes anymore, but rather accelerate, I should be in the air, no problem. It's so much harder to take off compared to War Thunder, but it should be, after all this is a real simulator, unlike, I mean, in the finer details there is really no compare. Okay. And I think we're off. Maybe if I lower the flaps, that will also help. I'm also carrying 6 PDFT bombs, but okay, I'm in the air properly, finally. So retract the wheel. And go into climb mode. Okay. We will go to the field warehouse. Or the tank workshop. Well, the tank workshop is closer, I guess. Look at the chat message. Stuka, race gear. He forgot that the Stuka cannot race the gear, I guess. Now he's laughing a bit too much at that. Stuka, please race gear. Give me a show. That's a good answer. Should we tell him, guys? I don't think he knows. Nah, leave it. Says Atomic Buttocks. When you got a sort of nickname, anything you say is more fun than it ought to be. Okay, I'm starting to wait. Of course, I didn't open the radiators. I'm just asking for trouble here. This is the one that has the outlet coal and only them, right? Yeah, it's not like the 110. The 110 has also another radiator, the water and oil radiator. Tank workshop it is, I guess. I wouldn't go all the way to the sheets, sounds too dangerous. So should I do the dive bombing that this plane was originally conceived for? Which means going at high altitude, turning on the speed brakes, and then diving for the target. Might be interesting, I guess. Overheating again. It's summer. Okay. Ah, this is the Russian map, I think. Yeah, Marinovka, Leninsk, these are all Russian names. And in fact, it's running worse than the other one, where you gotta explain it to me. It seems they inverted the performance relation of the two maps. Apparently now the Baden-Platt map runs better than the Russian one. How is that? Okay, so basically the tank workshop is in front of Stalingrad, it seems. Yeah, only now I recognize the city shape. But in general, when I take the Ju-88 as first thing, I manage to do some damage and return to base. Let's try. It would be a good beginning to the map. Yeah, Paki, ciao! Come va? Domattina SnowRunner. Ieri ci ho giocato un pochino, anche se non ho streamato. Ho preso il Kolob, camion russo gigantesco, infatti sarà divertente. Hai provato questi giorni il multiplayer? Funziona di nuovo? Speaking about tomorrow session, I think we'll play SnowRunner with Paki, possibly. Turbo Tecno che non sa giocare. Non è l'unico, purtroppo su YouTube è pieno di persone che... Poi ci sono quelli bravi, ovviamente. Digli qualcosa. Spiegaglielo te. Andiamo a fargli un raid sul canale, diciamo, a pippa. Ma che stai a fare? Ok. Tu gli dai consigli e non vuole ascoltarli. E mica tutti. Purtroppo la gente... A volte fa di testa sua. Ok, tank workshop. At the outskirts of the city, it seems. Sì. Turbo Tecno. E dopo se calda. È uno streamer, quindi. Perché dici, gli parli, quindi. Stai proprio guardando mentre giocavo. Hey, who is it? Hello?
Guess what?
This is Pius.
Yes.
Yes, I finally hear your voice loud and clear. This is wonderful. This is wonderful. We gotta play together absolutely as soon as possible. Okay. Tomorrow
okay,
I'll do wartime.
I have an update. I haven't tried.
No, it was necessary. It was a shame, really, that it was impossible to communicate. Now we will have fun.
Okay.
Tomorrow afternoon, I'll play War Thunder.
Okay, I can go 12 British time.
Well, I do always the same times. You know them.
Okay.
We're almost at the objective now. Where is this tank workshop?
What is your game called again?
This is Sturmovik, EL2 Sturmovik. It's very, very good. Look into it. They often discount it. It's harder than War Thunder. Flying the plane is harder. But it's also more rewarding, especially certain roles. Like bombing is a lot of fun here. Since you enjoy bombing, it might be the game for you. Especially if you play the German sides. In fact, what? Look at the bomb that just went off that they released on that objective. They nuclearized it. That's amazing. What sort of bomb did he drop on that? My god.
Yesterday I got a kill on the IL-16. I killed an IL-16.
Ah, you killed an IL-16, huh?
Yes. Or I-16, I believe.
I-16, the fighter.
Yes.
Ah, yes, they're very maneuverable. It's not simple.
Even though I was in a bomber.
Good, you're improving, you see. The more you play simulation mode, the better you will get at it. And also,
no,
it's good for grinding.
Well,
it's still taking advantage of it, is still worthy of praise, I guess. Okay, the enemy anti-air is now engaging me. Let's try not to be shut down by it.
Disintegrated.
Okay, drop bombs. And apparently I was on target. Unfortunately the anti-air is shooting me still. Let's try to escape now. I guess this is the only pass that I can do on this target, and whether I survive is all to be demonstrated. If I can return, but no, I'm going down. Yeah. I don't know what got damaged, but it was something important. And unfortunately I'm also in enemy territory, so it won't count for stats. But at least I destroyed a good part of the objective. The anti-air. I don't know what got damaged, honestly. It didn't look like the plane was that much damaged. Ah, probably the tail, yeah. Probably it's the tail that got destroyed, and so I lost control. Well, at least I damaged it. Anyway, it's fighter time. Let's go with the fighter again. I've been flying a bomber for so long now. How many points? 19 points. If I could land this, I would have got so many points, but I got captured instead. Let's fly... Well, a BF wouldn't be too bad. The G2. Let's fly the BF 109
G2. 109.
Yeah, without... With the armory glass at rest, yeah, that's important, so that you can see behind. And reduce fuel. And I guess a green livery, since we are in the summer. Like this one. Rihikallio. Who's this guy? Rihikallio. From the Finnish Air Force, no less. So makes sense for it to be green. Finland is pretty green ever since I checked it last time. Ah, so you went to Russia. Excuse me, Paki speaking to me about SnowRunner, but this Italian, I'll tell him in Italian. Sei nato in Russia. L'hai presa la Gar, l'auto a sei ruote, quella è buona. È un ottimo veicolo. Ok, starting the engine now.
Ok, I'ma go in about 3 minutes because my father got some. Need to get up.
Roger. Ah, look what an interesting insignia. I guess it was the Finnish Axis Emblem, sorta reminiscent of the German one. Never seen it before. Okay, BF means we have the differential brake, but I can just take off. I mean, there's no need to go all the way around. This is very light. Combat mode and go. The gear won't collapse. And as long as I don't push the stick forward, I won't break the propeller, and that's be good. Hi Fred, thank you for liking the stream. I'm finally trying to go and finally get an air kill, since like always in this game it's so difficult. But also I make it difficult, because I go Russian every time. Unfortunately, the way this server is, you have... No, look at that. Yeah, it's typical. We have... but look at how stupid it is, because 38 German pilots, 24 Russian pilots. It's always like this every day. Everyone wants to fly German. The server doesn't enforce player numbers, and so it's always uneven like this. It's so annoying, really. I should just play Germans and go with it anyway. It's what most people do. Stupid as it sounds. Every time you engage a German fighter as a Russian, you have at least the other three people diving for you. It's impossible. That's the reason I make the game so difficult for myself. By the way, I'm third at the moment with these 19 points. Too bad I couldn't bring them back to base. Then they would have been multiplied. Okay, I guess I'll go guard the big cluster of objectives. All these bridges are so closely spaced together that the enemy will love to go for. So I presume. It won't take as long this time we're in a fighter. No, but I will just head for the front lines anyway. They will have to come through that area. But also you can see that the German players are better. Look how many of them are inside clans compared to the ones to the right. More serious about the game, more invested in it, so to speak. Sì, che poi paghi la prima mappa lì della Russia ti dà un sacco di potenziamenti. Anch'io mi sono fatto un giro stamattina. No, ieri mattina, quando non potevo fare streaming. E ne ho presi un bel po'. Comunque il Kolob è fantastico, domani lo faccio vedere, è un mostro, è enorme. Non te lo puoi immaginare. Troppo figo. Ok, let me try and check my six regularly. For a change. Okay, I should add a bit more south. I guess most of the fighting will take place above Stalingrad after all on this map. It's the usual. No, no, but it's better than before. Even despite the fact that I'm running the overlay with the semi-transparent shot, which used to take too many resources. Look at that. I maintain an average of 50 frames per second, but most of the time it sits between 60 and 70. It's an enormous improvement to how it was before. Okay, I spotted something over there. Yes. That's a plane. Let's go and check it out. Unfortunately, without 3D Migodo, it's impossible to tell what it is. It's not a balloon. No, it cannot be a balloon. is also heading left to right, which would mean it's heading west, which would mean it's likely to be an enemy. Let's see. Not much else I can tell from this distance. Coming at the same altitude, which is not ideal, but not too bad either. Still can't tell. From the side it's difficult. I'm in combat mode. It feels Russian to me, but I'm not sure. It's just a gut feeling. It's also flying a bit high for being a Russian, but that's not necessarily the truth. Now he's entering the clouds, which will make him even less likely to spot me. Except for the fact that he appears to be reacting somewhat. Guys, that looks Russian to me. I'm going to lose too much speed, however, like this. I don't know what he's doing. Okay, it's German. Never mind. The shape of the wind is a clear sign. Now he's coming into alignment for me, but it's a friend. Unless he's actually dying for something else. No, it was just a maneuver that he performed to put himself to safety. But he was a friend, so it's all right. That looked very cool, I gotta say, yeah. This game can look cool even without combat at times. That was a pretty interesting encounter that we had. Well, let me slow down. I don't want to break another engine. At least let's try to be shot at by the enemy before we go down. Of course, I can only find the fighters when I fly a bomber. This is the more or less the rule of the game for me. Okay, they attack the artillery position, 0927. That's pretty close to my location. Let's go. Let's stay above, below the clouds so that I can spot better. The artillery position are inside the woods to the north of the city before the river. And they're still under attack. We have absolutely no visual. Let me check the six. Nothing over there. Yes, Stalingrad. For what the game is rendering. Of course, it doesn't render almost anything until you actually turn the plane. In VR, at least, it works like that. Annoying as it is. Should be right above the objective now. Yeah, these are the artillery positions, I guess. And we also found a plane that is German. I think. It looked German to me. The enemy attack dance. Yeah, that's still a friend. Let's follow him. He might have visual on something. As you can see, it's not so difficult to identify after all. Not with the index. With a normal headset, I would probably have trouble. But with this one's resolution, 3D Migot or not, I can still play, I think. I will be a bit less efficient, but not so terribly worse. Of course, the difficulty in finding targets is even worse when you're flying German, because there are less targets by definition. It's the unevenness of the server that kills it. But we got no other alternative, so... These are the artillery position, I guess. him three teammates and zero enemies in combat box. Shit's rough. They thought I was doing it on purpose. Well, I would think the same at the third one. I would think the same. Maybe at the second, they're saying the same thing three times is too much. Just have no targets here. Shall we move a bit to the enemy airfield? Well, I guess if the action really doesn't come my way. Ah, excuse me, Paki. Sono esplorato da Zara. L'ho scritto di usare il freestyle e metterci a WD e trazione. Mi ha bannato di scrivere in chat. Ah, beh, allora non ti sprega per lui. Vieni da streamer che ti ascoltano come me. Se questo è un cafone non ci merita niente. Ok. Here we have something. Diving. Diving pretty hard, in fact. If it's a friend, he might be aiming for the enemy. If it's an enemy, he might be aiming for the objective. In either case, we gotta follow this guy. You see? I think it's easier to follow enemies, even without 3D Migodo. Because you got better performance, and so you don't lose them as easily. Yes, I have no idea what I'm following. I think he might be Russian, honestly. Should I shoot? Does he look Russian to you? Yes. Yes, he does. No, he was a friendly. I was so sure. Oh well. And they even managed to do the interception perfectly. And they even had good aim for once. God damn it. I was so sure he was an enemy. I wasn't so sure, let's say the truth. Unfortunately, the lack of 3D Migodo is hurting me. Okay. Okay, that's an enemy because he's attacking the ground. And we are above a friendly objective. Let's try to make up for my big mistake. Here it is. Now I'm being self-conscious. I don't know. I won't shoot until I'm sure this time. Something else above there. I'm not sure. I just am not. Let's try to climb more so that maybe I can see the insignia on the wings. From behind they all look mostly the same. It looks like the one that I shot by mistake. I cannot attack him as much as I like to. Not without an 8 and level of zoom. No, besides, I think it's a BF. It's also too fast not to be a BF, I think. Yeah, he's returning to base. Per 10 minuti, non 10 secondi, mi sembrava 10 secondi da troppo poco. Vabbè, ma tu non chiedi niente. So I do have good aim sometimes, yes, when I'm attacking the friends, I have good aim. God damn it. God damn it, I feel so bad. Ok, they're still attacking the artillery though. Come on, I must find the target. Don't let me down. Me lo segnalo per parole scorrette. Ammazza, non perdoni. Vabbè, ma lascialo stare, ma che ti importa. That's the crash of our plane, I think. You keep attacking this thing right underneath my nose. E sto cazzo. Ah, ma è italiano. Hai capito? Still no visual on anything. Let's go toward the enemy base, I guess. Anyway, they will come from there if they attack the artillery positions again. I'm half tempted to go test the game performance in single player. I don't know. It's become a bit boring to me again, this game, when you don't have another voice inside of the game. You just look and look for targets in the end. It can become a snooze fest. That's my fuel, by the way. I'm starting to have little fuel as well. Will become a problem. The enemy attacked the crossing, 1324. Oh! Hmm. By the altitude of it, it's probably a German. One Russian will fly all the way up there. Makes no sense. But I'll follow him, I guess. Excuse me, that's smoke. Or isn't it? Yeah, very good visibility over the entire area of the map from here. They would have to cross for getting from the closer objective to the objective. From the closer F to the objective, I mean. So, in theory, if I could spot things, but of course in this game, you know how it is. This is boring. Let's say the truth. After all, it's better to go bombing, I guess. If you want to do fighter, you should do Germans. Allies. At least you have more targets to look for. I keep seeing the smoke, but it seems to be part of the scenario also because there's no objective there. I think it's supposed to be just the ground battle. Hey James, hello, no. At the moment there isn't. It's much better, James, you have no idea. In fact, now is not excellent. I'm at 37, but earlier on the bottom plat map it was night and day. It was 50 FPS or 60 even. Okay, they got me. Ah, god damn it. I'm going down, I think. Completely snipered. god damn it, my friend Cons at the bad time, I wanted to show how cool I was. And now he's gone, and well, I might try to escape, I guess. No, it's better, the performance is better, gents. Much better. Oh, someone is helping me, but I'm still going down. And I don't think I can recover. No, I should have jumped when I had the occasion. And now I will just crater together with the plane! well. He doesn't talk. Bruce, are you on my JU-88? Oh well, I guess. Finish spectate. Let's have another go at it. Marinovka? Kotluban is better. They were there anyway. Same plane. I wasn't disliking the plane, just the occasion. But anyway, should I use the elevator trim to pull you out? Elevator trim? But the BF doesn't have a trim, does it? I don't think you can set your trim on a BF. Okay. No air kills today either, James. Been having a hard time. But mostly to find targets. Anyway, I must say that the lack of 3D Megalodon doesn't disturb me much in the spotting proper. The problem is identifying planes. In fact, I did a friendly kill earlier. I was sure it was an enemy. Yeah, it was a fourth try to see if it had a trim, but it doesn't. No, because the BF has three tabs. I remember this little fact. Basically, they're set at the ground by the ground crew. The pilot doesn't control the trim of the plane. Very German way of thinking. The pilot must only pilot, not think about the trim. Did I raise my gear? Yeah, I see the message. I think they call it vertical trim axis. Ah, then I don't have it set up. Ah, then you know what you're speaking about, but I don't. I don't have it. I gotta set it up, I guess. I don't know on which axis I could put it. As you know, I'm a bit short on axis. Ah, did you get your controller back, by the way? You were having it exchanged, the multi-axis thingy that you have. I got my face mask back. Eh? In fact, they sent me two of them, not just one. They were pretty cool, I guess. Took them some time, a couple of weeks without index, but still, in the end. And also, I have a spare now, which I didn't, and that is also nice. I think the item performance is especially good when following targets. Like a low altitude, it's much easier to follow a target and try to shoot it down. You just set it to the same thing as your elevator trim control, but not both. Makes sense, makes sense. Ah, ho capito, Buggy. Beh, vedi un po', vedi un po'. Ogni tanto anche a me è capitato. Se si comportano male, direi che ci sta. In fondo esiste una TOS, una codice di condotta, no? Any plane will have one or the other, but not both. Okay, let me see it. Vertical trim axis, you were saying. Thanks for the tip, James. As always. Key mapping, I guess. Plane controls. Vertical trim. Iron trim. Pipe recovery system. It's not elevator trim, I think, no, because that is already set. I don't see it. Rudder trim, elevator trim, aileron trim axis, adjustable stabilizer axis, no. I don't see it. Hey, I hear a voice. Hello?
Yeah, I'm
Ah,
back.
Chris, hello. Come back.
My meeting was cancelled, so.
Okay, I'm flying German now, still on Wings of Liberty, but I'm in a fighter at the moment.
The server is nearly full.
Yeah, they connect.
Now it should be full.
You joined?
I'm joining, yeah.
I'm on German side, huh? Unfortunately, like always, we have 50 German pilots and 32 Russian pilots. So it's bad either case. Now, if you go Russian, you find in these situations where you have like three enemies on you at any given time. If you go German, you cannot find the enemy proper. I've been flying like 40 minutes. I found one enemy that killed me. It's a bit annoying to play on this server, but then again, there is none other. It's the only server that is populated at this time of day. So, enemy attack the advanced airfield. Okay, I'm heading just there. Might be the group that got me. 1026, I thought I cannot see the message anymore, but I think it was in 1026. And James, you were telling me adjustable stabilizer axis. I don't see it, I don't see it.
From which airfield should I fly?
I started from Kotluban and I'm heading for the airfield objective.
Which 109 do you use?
The G something, the
Oh,
G14,
G2. I could use G2.
G2, I don't remember, the higher letter of them. Unfortunately, I don't know the 109s very well. I normally go for the one that is higher, in number or letter. I know it's not very scientific, or maybe even advisable. So you're flying a fighter now, you can, you set your control again.
I think I should
Ah, that's
set
some
the
good news.
controls.
Okay. No, but in fact, I'm going for the enemy airfield, and the message was speaking about our airfield that was under attack. So I should probably just go in free hunting mode and maybe this time be more aware of people that might die for me. Should stay above the cloud as a BF probably. I think they also improved the graphics of the clouds, huh? They seem more natural, more organic almost. There's more layers of them too. Look at that, 1, 2, 3 different layers of clouds. I think the game used to have only one layer of cloud. In fact, when we were playing with giants every day, we used to say above the clouds, below the clouds, because there was only one layer. They did a pretty big overhaul of everything with this patch. After all, 7 GB of patch.
Good, I'm airborne.
Ah, nice. Franco Truban, eh?
Yeah.
I'm straight to the south of it, advanced column. And I'll keep heading south, what I think, yeah?
You should cover the airfield.
The airfield to the northeast from where I am. Okay, then, I'll head that direction. You're heading to the airfield?
Yeah.
Objective, which is 0727. Okay, I'll be joining you. Coming that way while keeping my eyes on the swivel. I don't want to be surprised again in the same way. That was annoying. The enemy attacked the crossing, 1223. It's on the southern part of the map. It's a very cloudy scenario, this one.
Nasty contacts. Over the airfield, 2 contacts.
Okay.
I think.
I'm in between the enemy airfield objective and artillery position. I'm still far. I'm coming anyway.
Altitude of one guy is 1 kilometer, 1,000. Yeah, 1,000. The other one is diving right now.
Above the airfield, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Should be able to see them in a minute or so. Following the river to it. Two squares away, no? Maybe less. Attack the crossing again. Did I see some movement to my 2 o'clock?
Over the airfield are 5 contacts.
Ah, wow.
One is shooting right now.
Wish I could see.
6 contacts. A lot of contact.
The airfield in 0727, right? Huh?
The airfield in, yeah, it was captured by the enemy, that airfield.
Oh. I'm not sure I'm looking at the correct one then. Because in fact I see no targets.
The airfield at 10:26.
Ah, you went the exact opposite side of where I am. 10:26, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, that's the enemy airfield.
Right now, yeah, they captured it.
Okay. Coming back. Too bad I was there. God damn it, I went for the other airfield. Well, I'm coming back. It will take a while though.
You have won 10 two times, but there was something else.
Trying to come back fast as I can. Oh, I see smoke, and now
yeah,
I see
one
there.
Is going down.
That's above the artillery positions, I think, though it's not the
yeah.
airfield.
It's next to the airfield.
Yes. Okay, that one is gone. I'll try to climb more. I want to stay above the clouds with this plane. G2, yeah, it's the BF-109 G2. I think I'm seeing a contact very faintly, very far away. Yes, probably that's the direction of the airfield too, so it would make sense.
Over the airfield are 2 110s and 1 JU-70.
Okay. So they're attacking it, I guess.
Yeah.
On my way. I'm above the airfield.
One is behind me.
Okay, still away. Unfortunately, I'm at the artillery positions now. If you hit northeast, I might be able to do something. I don't know. That is, if I can find you. Which is not easy in this game, unfortunately. The enemy attacked the artillery position. Ah, two. Which is where I am, by the way.
Okay, it was a 109. Oh, he's fighting!
Okay, I see some movement in front of me. I see the combat. I see the dogfight. I have two contacts, one diving, one climbing. I guess I'm above the airfield. Following the one that is more or less on my same altitude.
I should be on a 109. Yeah. It's definitely is a 109.
I'm currently north of the airfield. Where are you? Compared to the airfield, I mean.
North of the airfield.
I think I might be following you then. Are you on a left turn?
I'm in a right turn climbing
then
up.
Then it's not you. Then it's not
I am lining up on a 109.
Okay. I think I'm doing the same, in fact.
Altitude 900 meters.
Okay, my altitude is...
I'm heading now back to the airfield.
2002. Okay. I'm on a left turn to the north of the airfield, still following this 109. In fact, I won't follow him anymore. I want to go a bit more to the objective, I guess.
Cooling down my engine again.
Okay. Ah, yeah, James, tomorrow. No, tomorrow I think I'll do War Thunder. The day after tomorrow I'll do this. If you want to come, it would be my pleasure. Okay. I'm now northwest of the airfield, heading for the airfield.
I'm northeast right now.
Okay, northeast.
Northeast altitude 1,400 meters.
So you're a bit, you're quite a bit below me because I'm 3,000 at the moment. Hey, hi, Jelly Boy, welcome to the stream from Twitch, no less. Okay, I'm descending a bit and I see some movement above the woods.
I'm now about.
Okay, I see something. Hey, thank you for the follow. Can I look at your name now? I can very faintly see
There was water
something.
line.
Okay, low altitude. It's now clear the woods. And unfortunately, I lost it because without the super zoom from 3D Migodo, it's very hard to follow things. But I see tracers, yeah. That's definitely combat that's in front of me. I see the tracers at the very least. Not the plane, it's completely invisible. But I see the tracers. These look like German tracers, really.
White wingtip should be German, right?
Yes, I think the German is on the tail. Do you see the combat?
No, I'm following someone else right now.
Okay, I'll tell you my location. I'm past the river southeast of the airfield, following these two guys. I think the German is in the tail.
I'm north side, north of you. Yeah, it's a German one.
Okay, I can faintly tell the shape of the aircraft. They're still chasing one another. And now the Russian is climbing. He's trying to rush back to the airfield, to the base airfield, I mean.
What was the altitude of that fight?
Deck altitude. They're still there somewhere. Unfortunately, they completely disappear for me when they stop shooting. The truth of the matter is, rearm is the zooming mod that currently is not available. I think the Russian is down. Because I saw something hit the ground. No, wait a sec.
German should be down. There was one
The German was
dying.
chasing, I think, in the scene I'm looking at. Anyway, one is still flying. You know what? I think the German is down because this guy is still flying for his base. I don't think he knows I'm here, but I'm not catching up. They're still flying, both of them. Now I see them. I'm almost at the enemy base, unfortunately, to chase them.
Still have no visual on it.
We're all the way to the enemy base now. We're like 5 kilometers from it. I think I should turn back, honestly. Anyway, this guy is much closer than me, and eventually we'll get the kill. Oh, there's more planes now joining the action. Okay, I'm turning after something, and that's a Russian plane. And that's a Russian plane. Okay, it's a MiG, I think. No, it's a LuG. Shooting a bit. Oh, someone else is on my tail. Well, then shoot. Try to get the guy before he gets you. I damage him a bit. I damage him a bit more.
Which base?
Sednya al-Hahuba. But unfortunately, now the Russian is behind me, even though I did damage him. But the problem is not him, the problem is the wingman, which is following me pretty well. I like him. I'll die for the guy. Let's try to get the kill before I die. Come on. I couldn't. Okay, now pull, but not too much. I'm still flying. I think I should escape at this point. I'm faster than them. To turn after them in a damaged BF would be a suicide, I think. Unfortunately, he's also following well. I'm trying to make it happen for him, but I don't think it will happen. No, in
I
fact, it
see the
didn't.
tracers.
I just got killed. I just got killed. If you head there, there's at least a couple of enemy planes.
And I was on fighting action, so... Down.
Hey, hi, Mustafa! Hey, the dude is Italian, he should be with the Axis. I'm with the Axis today, Mustafa, I'm flying ABF. Yeah, I could even fly the Italian plane. Eh? Why not? Why not? I was flying ABF, yeah. I'm with the Axis today. Today, depends on the intention of the day. Well, unfortunately, I got killed above the enemy base. I wonder if that guy is going down, the one I damaged. Okay, taking off on Kotruman, I guess, and I'll go with the G2 again, because I was liking it. Coming straight to the airfield, where the action seems to be. Finally, we found where the action is. Airfield conditions got changed. Ah, we're out of G2s. Then I guess I'll go for the F4. The F4 doesn't have the transparent... headrest, unfortunately. No. Eh, well, we will have to do. Let's spawn and see how it goes. I always come so close to getting the kill and yet I never do. I guess I should be glad at least I come close to it, but it's frustrating. The other day was the same. It was the same. Every time when I'm almost... scoring, someone else comes and gets me. The problem is, people are in constant communication with their wingmates. I'm very good at it. Okay. Taking off again. You're still over the airfield?
Yeah, I'm fighting against one.
Oh, okay.
Time.
Good luck.
Oh shit, I've got now four behind me.
Ooh.
Oh, well, damn it! They nearly crashed.
You're still in the air?
I'm down.
Okay, then I'll wait for you to respawn. I'm above Kotruban. In fact, Kotruban is under attack, by the way.
Yeah, it's under attack, I noticed.
More the reason to overfly it. Hey, I hear another voice. Hello?
Oui, oui. I am so sorry.
It's Pius, huh?
Yes.
Ah, yes. Okay, no, excuse me, I cannot see the name. In VR it doesn't show your name, so you gotta introduce yourself. Ah, I'm Pius. And then I'll know.
Okay,
let's see my friend respawn. In Kotruban, right?
Yeah, I'm in F1, F2.
Like me. Yeah, they were out of G2s.
Yeah, there's one F4, but I'm flying in the F2.
Okay.
I don't like the sound of the...
Hi Haron, welcome to the stream. I'm waiting for Chris to take off. I think I have eyes on him. This should be you. You're parked on the left part of the parking area, right?
Yeah.
In fact, just disappeared if it were you.
Yeah, I just disappeared. I just lost connection.
Ah, damn it.
Rejoining.
Ooh, I got a kill! The guy had damage! Finally, an air kill! After 2 hours! What the hell? You play War Thunder, if you don't get 10 kills in a match, you're a noob, basically. Here, if you get one kill, it's like, I got a kill! It's terribly complicated. Okay, then if you have to reconnect, I might start moving towards the objective, I guess.
I'm already...
You're already in? Ah, no, then I'll stay here. Let me look at you. Still Kotruban, right?
Yeah.
And I think I see you, yeah. I see the fighter starting. Who's this guy overflying? You're not in the air, right? You're starting the engine.
No, I'm starting the engine.
Okay.
I love the sound.
Ah, yes. The sound in general in this game is incredible. Yeah. Sound design is something else. You're moving now, right? You're
I'm
taking
moving
off.
now, yeah.
You're the one in front, not the one behind. There's two
Yeah.
taking off, okay. So you're turning toward the runway. That must be you, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
The other one is
It's just went straight. Yeah, they do it all the time.
Easy shit. When
Yeah.
there was alarm start, you were supposed to
There's a guy
start.
on the runway. Ooh,
Oh, that's
that
not
was
me, but
close.
yeah, that was close.
But it went okay.
I'm up.
I see you, I see you. I'm on your left. Hey, airfield operations are very dangerous in this game.
Careful, enemy left side of me is getting attacked by
Ooh,
anti-air.
you're right. Let's
He's
turn
diving,
into
I
him.
think.
Okay, I'll turn with you, huh? I think I see him. Yeah, he's very much above us. And now I would say he's above your right wing. Here he comes. I think he's diving. He might even be diving for you, huh? Not sure. Anyway, I'm heading same direction as you. On your six, I am, not him. Okay, there's an entire dogfight up there. Look how many contacts. I count at least one, two. Ooh, someone passed me right to left. This looks German, though. Yeah, that's a BF.
Yeah.
You're smoking pretty hard. In fact,
Enemy is
it's easy.
diving. Enemy is diving.
It's easy to tell who you are because you're smoking. Okay. There's a lot of action over this
Yeah,
airfield.
I'm still chasing the enemy.
Okay, I'm behind you. I'm not pushing my engine as much as you. I can see that you're pushing it pretty hard. It's smoking a
Yeah.
lot. I see tracers. Someone is shooting. He's
Yeah.
behind you, but he's not shooting you. I think it's a friend shooting someone
It's
else.
a friendly shooting the enemy.
It looks like that. Yeah, the color on the tracers is a dead guy giveaway.
Good hits, mate. Good hits.
He got it. Ah,
Nice
okay.
one.
Good for the war effort.
So,
All these
should
planes are all
we?
friendly?
Yeah, the rest of us all friendly.
Ah, okay. They were all attacking the same guy, I guess. And now to tell which of these is you will be difficult. What are you doing currently? Climbing, turning?
I'm climbing. I'm now at 800 meters, climbing
Oh,
back to 1,000 meters,
Skype.
heading to the airfield.
You're turning right?
No, I'm flying straight.
Okay. Maybe you're right above me. You're flying toward the airfield.
Toward the enemy airfield,
Ah, the
yeah.
enemy airfield objective,
The
okay.
objective airfield, yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to gain altitude. I'm afraid I don't have visual on you. Well, I might, I don't know. There's so many planes. One of these could be you, I guess, but I have no idea which. Can you easily flash your lights, maybe?
No, but I see a contact from 11 o'clock fast.
Okay, what's your location on the map?
Doing a slight left turn.
Oh.
Location is 0926.
26, eh? Ah, you're much
Yeah.
too. I was looking at different location. Okay, I see some movement in that direction, in fact. Wow, four contacts. Two seems to have their lights on for some reason. And now one has turned them off. And the other two. They're cooperating. They're certainly cooperating. They were finding one another. Now he turned on his lights again. The one to the right also. I gotta climb though. I'm much lower than everything else.
I'm on the deck right now.
Ah, okay. Someone is mugging guard, got hit. I guess the action is over the artillery positions. You're still heading for the airfield?
I'm over the artillery positions right now.
Ah, okay. There's someone going down from above you.
I was chasing one, but it disappeared.
Oh, I know. It happens constantly in this game. I have a lot of contacts heading the artillery positions. Two in the clouds, right above me. And then there's two, three, where the guy got shot down.
Tracers.
Tracers, I don't see them.
They have three contacts. Stop fighting. Position
1027.
Ah, yes. Altitude might be 1200.
No, the one I see are 0927. So there's more groups, even more. The one I've been tracking for a while. So you're pointing at the one more to the right, or where I'm looking, I guess. I'm now at the artillery positions, I guess, because I had all these contacts and I didn't want to turn my eyes away from them. And they're definitely dogfighting. Someone is diving pretty hard. No one is chasing. I don't understand what he's doing. These look like... they both look like German planes to me. Okay, I see the tracers. And I think I just witnessed an enemy getting shot down. But I'm still following. No, the tracers are definitely white. But the other guy is still flying. I guess I'll shoot him too. I might steal the kill. I won't look away from the opportunity. I mean, a kill is a kill in this game. It's so difficult to achieve. Well, I did put some bullets into him. I wonder if I managed to steal it. I don't know. I have to resort to this at this point. That's German, okay. Apparently, no, it didn't work. Was already dead.
I see the one with his lights on.
Okay, now I have no visual on people with the lights on, but you are at the airfield, I guess, not at the artillery positions.
I'm flying next to the artillery position right now.
Okay, what's the direction from it?
Right now it's east.
So to my left, altitude. What's your altitude?
1250.
Okay.
Our artillery position is under attack.
Okay. Like you... Ah, the message, okay. But you haven't seen a bomb.
Yeah, I saw tracers.
Okay. They're strafing it then. You know, they don't even... I'm not sure where they are. I think... Okay, it must be this series of emplacements. By the road, in between the two wooden area. Let me see if I can see anything happening on these targets. Yeah, these are the artillery
positions. One is behind the one with lights, and another one is also on there. Yeah, two 109s and one... I think it's an LA.
Okay. Above the artillery positions?
Above the artillery position, yeah.
And right above them, I don't see these guys. If these are indeed the artillery position. Artillery positions are that series of...
I'm hit!
Okay, what's your location?
There are many enemies.
How is it possible I don't see them? I'm right above the artillery position.
I am flying at a 50 degree angle and I'm still gaining speed.
Ah, you're playing War Thunder at the moment, Pius.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, I think I see you. You're smoking white, Chris.
Should be, yeah. I'm
okay.
Here.
Then I have you in my windshield. I'm following you.
Then
someone is shooting, but he's shooting the other direction from where you're heading.
Retreat.
Okay, I see you seem safe at the moment. No one is chasing you. I'm coming together with another German, and now I see all the targets you were speaking about. There's a lot of them. The German is engaging
our
Russian.
I should get one on my six. LA5.
My God.
I
see you. Then it's not you, because the guy I'm seeing is not on fire. It wasn't you then. I wasn't looking at you. I'm now inside the dogfight. I don't know what to do, honestly, because I'm surrounded by planes of all types, turning after one and hoping for the best.
Ooh! My aircraft explode.
Wow. Okay. I'm following something. If I had the 3D Migoto mod, I could tell what it is. Unfortunately, lacking that, I just hope it's actually Russia. From behind, it's very difficult for me to tell. I guess the fact he's flying so low makes me think he's Russian, but then again, I'm German and I'm also flying low. There's even more contacts in front of me. I'm now to the northeast of the artillery positions, and we're getting away faster. There's another couple of contacts. Still chasing this thing that I don't know what it is. Deck altitude. Okay, someone's attacking the ground for some reason. I see white tracers, I see a plane. I could turn after, maybe. I'm too low. But everyone is low at this point. That's Russian, yeah. Go, go, increase the speed. That look Russian to me. Two people crash at the same time. This guy tried to strafe the guy while he was crashing. I'm still chasing him, but apparently he's faster for some reason. I don't want to overwork the engine. They break so suddenly in this game, they should have a warning to tell you slow down a bit before you actually destroy the engine. Unfortunately, sometimes you're just flying and bam, the engine is dead. So I'm very scared to push the engine. The tech talk should include that kind of warning. Okay, the guy I was chasing is definitely disappeared now. I don't know where he went. I guess I'll turn left and I see a lot of action left. This is in the blue airfield, the airfield on the top of the map. Objective airfield. Auron. Now the enemy is there. And there's a dogfight down low, which I might try to join. Perhaps. Let me see. Okay, I always see the Germans firing, of course, there's twice as many Germans as Russians. So the difficult part here is finding a target that hasn't been destroyed already. That's definitely German, which makes him the Russian, I guess.
It's nearly 5 p.m.
Okay, that guy parachuted. What time is it? Ooh, it's late, you're right.
Yeah.
We have the exact same times, don't we? We start and stop at more or less the same time. I could shoot one guy now, but I honestly am not sure it's not German. Since I already did this today, I wouldn't want to get another friendly kill. I'm trying to be sure. Try to climb, maybe I can see the wings. Task accomplished. I'm now very close to this guy. That's a German plane, I think. Yeah, it's German, now I can tell. Practically, when you're at the gang convergence distance, then I start to understand what I'm pointing at. No sooner than that, without the VR mod. Unfortunately, the level of zoom for VR is just insufficient by default, and since they updated the game, we don't have the mod anymore. Well, okay, I guess this is my last sortie now that you made me notice the time. So I might as well stay here and try to find another target.
I'm out, mate. Have fun. See you.
Okay, tomorrow. See you tomorrow. I'll be playing War Thunder tomorrow in the afternoon if you want to join.
And what do you want to play in the morning?
In the morning, probably not a flying game. I was going for the off-road driving game that I have. Ah, you play Spin Tires. Did you get SnowRunner?
I don't have SnowRunner.
It's good, huh? It's good. It's a bit it's buggy, good. But when it works, it's awesome. I think it's a great improvement, a very ambitious and well-made game. Yes, yes, I was planning to play that. Well, okay.
So, let's see. Tomorrow afternoon.
Tomorrow afternoon, for War Thunder. Okay.
Let's break some guys.
Will be my pleasure. With pleasure, indeed. Guys, there's still combat here. Yeah, tell me.
Have a nice day.
Same. Bye bye. Thanks for playing. It was fun indeed. Let's find something to destroy in these last 5 minutes that I have. It's a really short time, really. I cannot even return to base. I would hope for the enemy to engage me, otherwise I'll just have to disconnect. These days we are finding some of the old wingmen again, they started playing again. I guess, paradoxically, the quarantine meant that people had less time to play. I don't know why. Seems strange. And yet I lost so many of the old wingmates that I used to have in War Thunder. No. And seeing them again, it's a nice thing. Okay, guys, I see something on my six. Normally you shouldn't tank for it, but like I said, I'm short on time. Let's see if it's a Russian. I hope I don't lose it, as I might just have. Ah! No. We're flying deck at you with a BF, that's also quite peculiar. Not the best tactical choice. Let's climb a bit, I guess. I might as well, anyway. Unfortunately, the FBF doesn't see behind very well. Okay, now we're a bit higher, but very slow, which makes us vulnerable. Here it is. I found him again. Now it's easier to follow too. He's producing some smoke. And I lost him again. But he's there, huh? Where am I heading now? I'm more or less standing around the earth. Here you are. I think it's a German. I think he's friendly, but I'm not sure. No, it's a German. I don't know why he's flying so low. That's the typical BF shape. What time is it? 56. Well, let's follow him. He might bring me to the enemy. Ah, there's action there. Yeah. We found another dogfight. Go, combat mode. Of course, I mean, if you value your time with your game in terms of number of kills and points that you scored, it's difficult to have fun. Sometimes you have good days, but the problem is, it's just a matter of luck whether you find yourself in situations in which you matter, it's difficult to know where the enemy will attack. That's the point. And if you guess wrong, you end up flying in circles again and again. So for me, the value of the experience should reside with the actual experience of flying the plane, of intercepting things, spotting things. And that's also part of the skill set that you need to be efficient in multiplayer here to Sturmoy. And well, we know very well how difficult it can be to actually achieve something. Unless you go for bombing only, then okay, the bombing targets don't move and you can count on that. That guy has got his lights on. Try to get a second air kill, come on, only one is disappointing despite all I'm saying. To get only one air kill is still disappointing. I should count in my mind the times I come close to getting an air kill as well. Why am I seeing the lights but not the flame? What is this? Okay, it's farther than I imagine. Really, really out of time. Come on, give me some final action. Been chasing things at ground altitude for a while now. But I'm reaching that guy, yeah? Now we're going very, very fast as we can possibly go at this altitude. And then catching up, whatever it is. That's German, unfortunately, yeah. We've been chasing a friend once again. And guys, I think I gotta go. Yeah, it's possible I might eventually find a target, but I don't deem it likely at this point. I have found how many targets since I started playing. Like, the problem is I didn't meet the planes. The times I met them, I won 50% of the times. It's just the nature of this game. Hey, still looking James Dean cool in that VR gear, lol. Thank you, Greg. Yeah, it's cool. I like to play this way. It's the only way I would play most of my games. I just enjoy it so much. So yeah, guys, like I was saying, I'm out of time. Was it a worthy session? Yes, indeed. It was. It was nice discovering the new performance of the game. I did a couple of bombing runs that went reasonably well. And didn't end it my death, no, because even the one where I got shot down, I was captured by the enemy, so didn't die. And I got an air kill and an half. Like I said, I should count in my mind the half when I almost got it, because otherwise you get discouraged with this game. It's not War Thunder, it's not a game where you get kill. You gotta understand it and be patient with it. I think it's the most important step in actually enjoying Sturmoik. So like I was saying my friends earlier, tomorrow morning, I might start later now that I think. Probably I will start around 9, not 8 in the morning like I do usually. But I'll try to start as soon as possible. And it will be, like I said, SnowRunner, the off-road driving game. Afternoon, War Thunder, and Chris will be there because he told me, so that's excellent. And everyone else is of course invited who might be still watching the stream. You're very much welcome if you want to play with us tomorrow, of course. For everyone else, and who are also invited, by the way, see you. Thanks for